गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स। न्यूट्रिएंट्स अर्लियर वी टॉक्ड अबाउट डाइजेशन। सो बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंड इन डाइजेशन, ऑल द कॉम्प्लेक्स फूड पार्टिकल्स वर कन्वर्टेड इनटू सिंपल सॉल्युबल फूड पार्टिकल्स। नाउ द प्रोसेस ऑफ एब्जॉर्प्शन टेक्स प्लेस। एब्जॉर्प्शन मीन्स दीज सिंपल सॉल्युबल फूड पार्टिकल्स विल बी transferred into bloodstream, they will be absorbed from intestine or alimentary canal into the bloodstream, and for bloodstream they are going to be provided to cells and cells are going to utilize them. So this is the process of absorption. Now absorption basically takes place of monosaccharides. After digestion of carbohydrates we have got various monosaccharides. Then digestion of protein has given us amino acids. There is fatty acids and glycerols which were obtained from the digestion of fats. Glycerol is there. Then alcohol, some drugs. So all these substances are going to be absorbed. Whenever absorption comes, the main part of alimentary canal that is going to absorb maximum substances is small intestine. That means 90% of the absorption of all these substances are taking place in small intestine. Other than small intestine, some other organs are also involved, like stomach, large intestine. So little bit of absorption takes place in small intestine and large intestine, and maximally the absorption takes place in small intestine. Now let's see how absorption of these substances takes place. Firstly, I am telling you the methods by which basically absorption takes place. There are various methods. For example, it can be osmosis. Osmosis, we know there is movement of solvent from higher concentration to lower concentration. Then it can be by active transport. That means the transport mechanism, the movement in which ATP is required, or our body is going to expend ATP and then transport takes place. Now it can be diffusion also. Substances are simply going to move from their higher concentration to their lower concentration. Then it can be facilitated diffusion. See, there is a difference between normal diffusion and facilitated diffusion. Both are the part of passive transport. That means no energy is required. But here, there is no assistance. No one is going to help in the movement of substances. Facilitated diffusion simply means there are some carrier proteins or carrier particles which are helping in the movement of substances. That's why we are calling it as facilitated diffusion. So these are the different methods by which absorption is going to take place. Now, how absorption of different type of substances are going to take place. First one is how absorption of monosaccharides happen. After digestion, various monosaccharides are present, like glucose is there, galactose is there, fructose is there. So these substances, basically if I am talk about glucose, glucose is going to absorb by the process of active transport. And glucose is not absorbed individually. Basically, it takes the help of sodium pump. That means it is moving along with the sodium. It is not going to transport alone. It is showing a support mechanism in which sodium and glucose are moving in same direction. So ATP is required, ATP is expended, and glucose molecules are being absorbed, and these are absorbed directly into the bloodstream. That means it is going to enter into the blood capillaries. Galactose also, sometimes galactose, movement of galactose takes place by active transport, or it can be taken by place by passive transport. Fructose, movement of fructose basically takes place with the help of facilitated diffusion. So all these monosaccharides are absorbed by different methods, and most of the absorption of monosaccharides takes place in stomach and jejunum region. Sorry. So this is the places where most of the monosaccharides are being absorbed. Now the second comes is amino acids. Amino acids are mostly absorbed by the process of active diffuse or active transport. Sometimes it can be very small amount can be absorbed by passive transport also, but most of the amino acids are transported by the, or you can say absorbed by the process of active transport, and it mostly happens in the duodenum and jejunum region. And plus these amino acids are also absorbed in blood capillaries. Why I am differentiating between blood capillaries? You will get to know when I will talk about fats or fatty acids and glycerol. So this is how amino acids are being absorbed. Now the most important and different process is taking place with the help of fats. That means fatty acids, glycerol and fat soluble vitamins. All these substances are basically insoluble in water. So there is a difference in their absorption. How absorption of fatty acid, glycerols and fat soluble vitamins are taking place? They are taking place with the help of micelle formation. Micelle, basically what is micelle? In micelle, these hydrophobic substances are basically going to aggregate in the center, and these are surrounded by some hydrophilic molecules. This is how micelle formation takes place. And in case of fatty acids and glycerols, these micelle formations are taking place with the help of bile salts. So this is a micelle, and how this micelle is forming? The hydrophobic fatty acid glycerol molecules are present in the center, and the surrounding portions are basically the hydrophilic part. These are the hydrophilic part, and the center one is containing the hydrophobic part. So now the hydrophobic part has not to come contact with the water, so it can easily be absorbed. This is how micelle formation is taking place. Now these micelle formation, here intestinal cells are present that are containing villi. This is how, this is suppose an intestinal cell. These micelle formations are entering, and inside these intestinal cells, endoplasmic reticulum are present. So these endoplasmic reticulum are taking these micelles, and they are going to resynthesize them, and they convert it into chylomicrons. Chylomicrons simply means the hydrophobic or fats are being surrounded by proteins. The outer covering is now of proteins, and these chylomicrons are going to enter into the lymph capillaries that are surrounding these intestinal cells. So this is the lymph capillary, or we call it as lactates. So absorption of these fatty acids takes place in lactates or lymph capillaries, and later on they will come into the mainstream, because finally the lymph is going to enter into the bloodstream, so they will move inside the bloodstream. This is how absorption of fatty acid takes place, and this process mostly takes place in the region of small intestine. Now some other substances like water is there. The absorption of water takes place simply by the process of osmosis. So water is absorbed by the process of osmosis. In alimentary canal, concentration of water is more, so it is going to move from higher concentration to lower concentration inside the intestinal cells and finally into the blood capillaries. Then some other substances like alcohol, drugs, they are mostly absorbed in stomach region, and some parts are also going to be absorbed in the small intestine region. Other than them, there are some vitamins also, plus there are some electrolytes. chloride ions, sodium ions, magnesium, different ions are present. These are also moving with the help of active transport in the intestine region. This is how different components of the food are going to be absorbed, and after absorption they are going to be assimilated, that means simply used by the body. In our next video we will discuss how assimilation of these nutrients takes place.